Welcome to Money Talk with Aaron Ricketts, presented by Ricketts, Ricketts & Associates, 3245 North Adrian Highway, Suite F. The opinions voiced on Money Talk are for general information only and are not intended to provide specific advice or recommendations for any individual. To determine which investments may be appropriate for you, consult with your attorney, accountant, financial, or tax advisor prior to investing. Securities are offered through LPL Financial, member FINRA SIPC. Aaron with us in the studio. Hey, Aaron.
Hey, John.
Well, things are still interesting, aren't they?
Yeah. Probably going to have the next few weeks. They're going to be tough for everybody.
Right, exactly. So what do we got going with people? I mean, I'm sure you're probably getting calls from people, and people
sure.
are concerned about everything that's going on. And I guess yep. you just keep talking about it, right?
Yep, we'll just keep talking about it. We can't predict anything in the short term. We always say we're, long-term planners, most of us advisors. That's how we do our job. And these short-term problems and, of course, this is a significant one, very similar to, the 2008 market decline. We've kind of maintained so far in the market a reasonable decline, but we certainly could see more pain in the market in the coming weeks, because we're probably not going to get any good news, right, that's coming out of the control of the virus for another couple weeks. Certainly, that's what we're hoping for. But I think I talked about a little bit, maybe two or three times before, recordings before. We talked about, how China dealt with it, when they kind of shut their country down like we have. And it took them about seven weeks before they were mostly fully open. And, if we kind of looking at us shutting down around March 20th to 23rd for Michigan, I believe. But, New York and other places had started it a little bit before then. If we look at that, we're still early in this recovery. I should say recovery. We're going to recover, but we're still early in this cycle. So if we follow the same thing happened in China, and maybe we've heard some good news the last week in Europe that things are starting to change because of their policies and implementations. But I wanted to talk about today the CARES Act that was passed, the $2 trillion that's coming economy.
Yeah.
And make sure that for the information I know now, or we know right now, I can get that out there and touch on some of those things. So rather than talking pleasantries, I'm just going to get into it and start rattling off some information from that act that's going to pertain to almost all of us. Of course, most of us know about the $1,200 stimulus payments that are going to be coming, and I would just advise everybody, get online and do some searching, and it'll tell you what the rules are and how you can get that money, and make sure that you're in line to get that money. And how I understand it, it's going to be automatic, so there's nothing you have to do to get it. You don't have to file for it. Now, if you haven't filed a tax return, they just said just in the last 24 hours, that if you are a Social Security recipient and you do not file a tax return because your income is below the filing requirements, you do not have to file. That is the latest I've seen coming out of Washington. This week, we just didn't know. I had a few calls from clients and others. I was talking to them. I said, let's just wait this out and see if they, make the right move, right decision. So if you receive Social Security and you did not file a tax return, you do not have to do anything. You're just going to get a check. So I want to let everybody know that. And, of course, anything can change anytime, so you might want to keep checking on that. But, again, there was quite the big news that was put out in the last couple of days about that. Okay?
Oh, so, Aaron, if you're getting Social Security, mm-hmm. those payments from the government are probably going to go directly into the account where your Social Security goes?
Yes, they will go right to an account, or they said even a card. You know, some people, a few, get on a debit card, get their payments on debit card because they don't have a bank account. But, yep, they'll be directly deposited right into your account.
Okay, that's good.
So if you are a person who doesn't receive Social Security benefits, there are some people out there that just get VA benefits, or they might get some other benefit, SSI, or I'm sorry, not SSI. They might get another type of benefit or some type of income. Some people don't get Social Security checks because they work for an entity, possibly, that didn't pay into Social Security. You may have to file a tax return if you do not, especially like young people. If you haven't been filing a tax return because you make $3,000, $4,000, $5,000, $10,000 a year the last couple of years, you need to go and file a tax return so you can get that check. Okay?
Okay, good.
All right. Retirement account changes, and sometimes things get lost in the bill is pretty big, pretty thick, but some things like this to me is very important. They're eliminating the early withdrawal penalty for those under 59 and a half, which is currently the rule for IRAs, to take money from your IRAs. If you need to, the income tax will still be required. You have to pay that, but that 10% penalty will be waived. And there's a lot of restrictions and different things on it, but if you're affected by this, which pretty much everybody is, if you need to take money out of your IRA, you're probably affected by this, right? The COVID-19 epidemic, or pandemic. So there's rules on that. If you need to take money out, make sure you're talking to your accountant, your tax person, to see how you can get those amounts waived when you file your tax return, okay? You can also take loans from your retirement plan, such as a 401k. They've increased that to $100,000 for 2020. The previous limit was $50,000. Temporary waiver of required minimum distributions for 2020. So nobody has to take their required minimum distribution for this year. So anybody that's now 72 and over that has a retirement plan, they have been required to take required minimum distributions each year, but you do not have to take them. They did the same thing back in 2008, just to let everybody know this isn't something they have not done before. So I know I have several clients that have stopped or reduced their monthly income. A lot of it is because they don't need it, right? They're on fixed income, so whatever monies they have coming in, when you stay at home, you spend a lot less money. So a lot of people have done that, and if you haven't talked to your advisor about that, or if you are taking a lot of people, let's say you have to take $12,000 from your IRA because you're over 72, so you're taking $1,000 a month just to supplement your income. If you don't need it, especially right now, you could just stop it, or you could just say, I don't want it for the rest of the year, because you don't have to take your required minimum distribution. Just a thought. There is relief for mortgage homeowners. So, again, I'm not a tax advisor, and I'm just trying to give that information that, you know, if you need help, get online, search out, coronavirus help or this CARES Act, C-A-R-E-S, and you can just do simple searches on that area that you are trying to figure out or get answers to. There's mortgage relief, and how I understand it, you can postpone up to 180 days. 6 months of mortgage payments, which is pretty good, but you have to be affected, by this situation, which, again, if you need to contact them, you're probably affected. So contact your mortgage holder or get online and do some research on that. Student loan suspension. They suspended payments automatically for federal loans through September 30th with no interest accruing or penalties during this period of suspension. Now, I have seen conflicting information about that say you have to contact the holder of the loan. I would suggest that you just do that, just to make sure that that's how it's going to work. But, if you have issues making those loan payments, contact your student loan holder and see if you can get those delayed. Small business owners, to me, this is the big one. I say a big one because I've tried to learn as much as I can about it and get the information out there to people that I think need the information. And that is part of this CARES Act. There's a thing called a payroll protection plan. And the whole idea is to get money to small business owners so they can keep paying their employees. Now, the program will provide cash flow assistance through this 100% federally guaranteed loan to employers who maintain their payroll during this emergency. If employers maintain their payroll, the loans would be forgiven, which would help workers remain employed as well as help affected small business, you know, businesses in the economy, especially like in your local areas. So it'll help, you know, keep them employed and then help the economy snap back faster. The forgiveness is up to 8 weeks, so it'll be 2 months of payroll based on an employee retention and salary levels. It's a little complicated. I'll talk a little bit about it, but again, you need to talk to, on these programs, your local banker. Almost all the banks and the credit unions are going to do this. So wherever you have your accounts, that might be a great place for you to start. This is, again, for small business owners. The highlights of this are, and I would say it's simple, but they're not. It's complicated, but some parts of it are pretty simple. What they do is you take all your payroll, all your wages for 2019, and you add that up, divide that by 12, and you take 2 months, and you're going to, you take a month, and you multiply that by 250%. So in essence, you're getting that 2 months, plus they're adding in another 25%. See, I know I try to describe this and it get a little complicated. If you're looking at it, you can see how it works. But again, you can get on, do some searching, talk to your banker. All of them are doing it. I've contacted, our office has contacted, First Federal and KeyBank and TLC and the others. They're all doing it right here. All your major banks are doing the SBA loans, and that's who they're going to be approved through. But it's through your bank. So as a business owner, you can go in and fill out an application. You can go to the SBA.gov site. I have done that. I have seen the form, and right at the top, you can click on fill out the application. It's supposed to start yesterday, Friday. So where they're going to start accepting the applications or start, I should say, reviewing them, and then however the process is going to work, that's what we don't know right now. But it is nice that the local banks are be able to do it. Then they're going to be busy, but they're going to be able to take care of this locally here for you if you choose. Some other highlights are then, let's say you had a monthly payroll of $5,000 as an example. So I said you take that $5,000 a monthly and you have 250%, right, is what you would do the calculation for. And you would come up with $12,500. So that would be your loan. And as long as you keep your employees working or you're paying your employees as much as you can, you can have that portion of what you paid your employees forgiven. So in essence, you keep your employees there and you pay them and the note at some point will be forgiven, the loan. You can also use your rent, your lease, any mortgage payments, utilities, you can use up to 25% of that as a forgivable part of that too. So again, there's some complexity to it, but the accountants are going to be on board with this in a very short time. Most of them know exactly what I'm talking about already, but you want to find out about it, and I'm going to suggest you probably do it, especially even if you don't retain employees. And maybe this is why you'll think you should do this. The interest rate on what's not forgivable is going to be 0.5%. There's been some numbers thrown out there that it was 4%, but it's actually 0.5%. There's a six-month payment deferral, so you don't have to make any payments back to the government or to the bank for 6 months. But there is a two-year repayment process, so you got to repay all that money that is not forgiven within 2 years. So I would suggest, even if you have, if you're a small business owner, even if you laid off your employees, that 0.5% interest rate is well worth you just filing, even if you have to pay the money back, because that may help you, you know, get by for the next couple months or 6 months or however long, you know, we need to, you might need that money for. So what are you thinking, John?
I'm thinking, take advantage of everything you can take advantage of. And you're still taking calls, right, Aaron, if somebody calls in?
Yep, you can give me a call. A lot of this stuff, you know, I certainly would talk about it that I'm talking about today. But I prefer that you talk to your banker or you talk to your accountant or both and, you know, do some research yourself to do that. Just don't miss out on this stuff, especially if you're one of those employers that still have employees working. Because your money, your loans that you receive, you know, most likely are going to all be, you know, waived. Now, I gave you that number of, you know, $5,000 a month of payroll. What if your payroll is $10,000 a month or right. $20,000 a month or $50,000 a month? I mean, there are businesses here, you know, in the local area, the county here, that have, you know, employees or employee payroll that size. The part of this law, this payroll protection program, is for companies with 500 or less employees. So next week, I believe Friday, this coming Friday, will be where the larger companies then can apply, those that have more than 500 employees. They can then apply for their loans and however that system's going to work. But this is directly related to, you know, small businesses, and that's what it's being the bankers and the SBA, the Small Business Association, that they're the ones that are administering this. So it's very important. There is another program called the, I don't have a name for it, it's just a tax credit program. So while you're thinking about, okay, should I, you know, maintain employees, should I lay them off? Because the concern is if you can't keep them working because there's no work for them, you know, the unemployment agency is providing quite the benefit right now, right? You're going to get unemployment and then the federal government's going to kick in, they're saying, right, an extra $600. So most people that, you know, are laid off, they're going to get their full wage for, you know, a month, 2 months, 3 months, at least to get them, you know, through this process. And I think it's a four-month, $600 a month is going to pay for 4 months. So that's pretty good. So a lot of employers, if they don't lay off all their employees, they might lay off a few of their employees, and then you can still use, right, some of this money as the forgiveness part of it. So if you don't use the money, you can always just give it back, right? You're not going to be paying much in interest, 0.5%, but maybe you need to, you know, upgrade something or do something you've been waiting for. To, you know, get a little cash in your hands to take care of some things. I think it's just like you said, there's an opportunity here and you don't want to let it go.
So contact your accountant or whoever advises you on your business dealings.
That's right. Talk to your bankers. I go right direct to the bankers. One thing I did want to say, all you private nonprofits out there, your veterans organizations, you know, the Eagles, the Elks, all those different private nonprofits, you got employees, you're a part of this program too. So I'm a part of a couple of those organizations. I've already had meetings with them, and we're going to start the process, or they're going to start the process to make a filing, just like anybody else, any other small business owner.
All right, Aaron, thanks for the valuable advice. We'll be talking again next week.
All right, thanks, John.
That's Money Talk with Aaron Ricketts, presented by Ricketts, Ricketts & Associates, 3245 North Adrian Highway, Suite L. The opinions voiced on Money Talk are for general information only and are not intended to provide specific advice or recommendations for any individual. To determine which investments may be appropriate for you, consult with your attorney, accountant, financial or tax advisor prior to investing. Securities are offered through LPL Financial, member FINRA SIPC. Join us once again next week for Money Talk here on 103.9 WLEN.